Welcome to World Class Championship Wrestling. I'm Bill Mercer with Jay Salley. Jay, American Tag Team Champions, Kevin and Kerry Von Erich, and a new tag team group tonight.
H&H revealing a new tag team tonight. We know what happened with the old one of Kong and McGraw. Tonight they're bringing out Wild Bill Arum, who's the Texas heavyweight champion, teaming up with the American heavyweight champion, King Kong Bundy. I feel that'd be a great tag team that H&H puts out there tonight.
And of course, we know Kevin has no love for Bundy, and you're going to see why. We've seen Bundy now without his hair. And Kerry Von Erich, he's working for that World Heavyweight Championship. We got a feature tonight that's really going to be exciting. Gary Hart has allowed us to film a workout of the martial arts of the Dragon and the Great Kabuki. And finally, Bugsy McGraw said this week, hey, watch out tonight, I'm going to bring some surprises. Well, we'll find out what he means by that as we wait for that first match with Bugsy McGraw here on World Class Championship Wrestling. We'll be right along with that.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and hello, Bugsy. Welcome to the world-famous Sportatorium for World Class Championship Wrestling, sanctioned by the National Wrestling Alliance, with your officials Bronco Lubitsch and David Manning. Your first event on tonight's card, one fall with a 10-minute time limit, from Guadalajara, Mexico, at 235 pounds, Pete Montrose. From Indianapolis, Indiana, at 301 pounds, Bugsy McGraw. David Manning, your referee.
World-class championship wrestling, and there is Bugsy McGraw with his associates, Jay. He's got quite an interesting group. One thing about his associates in that can, they don't vote, and they don't tell him what to do.
No, and they don't talk back either. One thing, Bugsy McGraw, a man who declared his independence on the 4th of July, 2 weeks ago. Independence meaning leaving the great association of H&H.
What are you going to check before you think? You know, it's interesting about his personality. He's always been outgoing, but he's become a rather likable person since his freedom sort of exploded on the world. And he shows us a side that there was a humor there all the time, but now it's kind of a pleasant situation. And he's still the tough wrestler he was.
Tell you what, a man who showed a lot of frustration ever since the Andre the Giant match at Texas Stadium. A man who seems to be on the right track now to being a successful wrestler once again, being that he is his own boss right now.
Well, in talking to him before this match, he said, I've got some surprises for you. So I don't know what he's planning to do, but he's starting off here with Pete Montrose from Guadalajara, Mexico. Wrestles around San Antonio a great deal. A stocky, well-built guy who's probably seeing a Bugsy McGraw with all his antics and wondering just where this man comes from. Well, if you give Bugsy time, he'll tell you. And certainly I found out where Bugsy will come from and what he'll do in a fun sort of way. David Manning, the referee, has a headlock in by Pete Montrose. And we've got excitement tonight. Coming up, the American Tag Team Champions, Kevin and Kerry Von Erich, in our world-class championship last night. They'll be meeting Wild Bill Irwin and King Kong Ball-Headed Bundy.
That's right. Kong lost all his hair in San Antonio. He's very unhappy about it. You speak of Kong, you've got to remember that he just got back from Florida where he beat up on the Florida's champion, which was David Von Erich.
So that must have made him happy, but he is really now out for the Von Erichs. But right now we're in the one-fall bout. Bugsy McGraw and Pete Montrose. Montrose trying to make a bit of a name for himself here against Bugsy, who many times were just like a cat toying with a mouse, or just got a play when he caught it, just like that, and then he gets really wound up, popping away. Roundhouse, right uppercut to the jaw.
Bugsy McGraw coming off two ferocious battles, one last night with the colorful face of Kabuki, and the night before that with the Texas heavyweight champion Wild Bill Arum. Both matches ended in a disqualification.
Oh, Big Bugsy stomping, looking, perturbing himself and his opponent as they battle here in world-class championship wrestling. We also have, as we talk about the American Tag Team Champions, an interesting feature coming up this evening. Watch Montrose right here. Oh, a reverse elbow drop. And Bugsy, like a big wild gorilla, thumps his chest and picks up Montrose for a hard body slam.
Okay, Montrose is over 240 pounds. Bugsy picked him up and threw him down very easily.
Oh, Bugsy going to the top. Going all the way to the top. Watch this ring work. Woo! Diving body slam.
Kind of missed it, but Bugsy told me about that move before the match. It's all over, Bill.
And I'm going to go down and see what I can find out from Bugsy.
Bill goes ringside with the intellectual favorite, Bugsy McGraw, just went her over the... I don't know too much about P. Montrose, but he's not a... I would say this one of McGraw's easiest matches that he's had. McGraw in the ring right now, showing some of his Three Stooges antics as Bill Mercer works his way to ringside to get an interview with the intellectual favorite, Bugsy McGraw. McGraw gets ringside, standing next to Bill. McGraw, fan favorite now, went from rule breaker to fan favorite. Now let's go to Bill Mercer ringside.
We got Bugsy McGraw. Hey, Bugs. What do you got? You got a fan club here?
Look at this microphone right down here. And you like surprises, don't you?
Yeah.
You like surprises?
Yeah.
I mean, you're on camera, boy. Speak up. We don't want to hear you.
Yeah.
You got it's like I told you people, I wouldn't lie to you. It's your Uncle Bugsy talking to you, you understand? This is reality. There will be surprises later on in this program. I want you to stay tuned because it's going to be something unusual, something you haven't seen before, and something you're really going to like, and H&H you're going to be surprised too.
Okay. Bugsy McGraw coming up. Coming up will be Al Madrill and Raul Castro. So stay tuned for more excitement on World-Class Championship Wrestling. And there he is, J. Alberto Madrill, the young man who wants that Texas heavyweight title shot again. He wants that championship, and here's his opponent, Raul Castro. This promised to be a very exciting match. Two very quick, very fast, very strong young men. And let's go now to Mark Lorenz.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match, one fall, 10-minute time limit. First from Cuba, 225 pounds, Raul Castro. From Los Angeles, California, at 235 pounds, Al Madrill. David Manning to officiate.
Al Madrill and Raul Castro. Madrill, very, very popular around the Southwest of World-Class Championship Wrestling. Always a hard worker, always ready to go.
Right now, man, Al Madrill, a man possessed with an obsession of winning back the Texas State Heavyweight Championship belt that he feels that Wild Bill Arron has stole from him. Madrill's been chasing him for some time. They've had some bouts in the past, which were good ones, but they were non-title bouts. Madrill still chasing Wild Bill.
And we open it up for the one fall bout. As we were going to tell you a moment ago, just as Bugsy McGraw finished off his opponent, Pete Montrose, I want you to stay tuned for a very interesting feature on the martial arts as you watch Kabuki and the Dragon working out at the very kind permission of Gary Hart. This is a very interesting display of how these two very famous Oriental wrestlers work out and prepare and maintain their tremendous talent of the martial arts. You'll see all the variety they use as we watch Al Madrill right now.
I tell you what, Castro's got his hands full tonight with popular Al Madrill. I look at this match for Al Madrill as just a tune-up for what something he wants real bad, and that's the Texas Heavyweight Championship.
That he does. So a nice arm drag. There's a good nightmare move by Raul Castro.
Last time we saw Madrill and Earn fight, it ended up being a disqualification match with both fighters ended up on the floor with Wild Bill submitting to a figure four lock after he opened up Al Madrill's head.
A very, very tough match. One thing you have to comment about earlier is that he always will defend that Texas title. Here's Raul Castro. Al Madrill slams him coming off the rope. And Castro.
Madrill using that closed fist. I said it before and I'll say it again. NWA rules, you're not allowed to hit with a closed fist. Everything must be hit with an open hand.
Yes!
And Madrill trying to get away with it and succeeds it this time. Down on top, count of two, but Castro sails him off there. Castro moves in. Castro giving Madrill trouble now. That's part of Buckley. I mean, coming up tonight. Kevin, the American Tag Team Champion. Castro. And roll up in his work now by Al McGill. Al's going to try to demask this man from Cuba.
If they're lacking in talent out there in the ring, Al trying to pick up the interest of the fans by distraction of the wrestling into unveiling the face of Raul Castro. Never seen him without his mask, just like the spoiler. But Castro knows something of his own, which is a rake across the eyes.
And a head spin, which is very tough on the ears and side of the head. Now going for a reverse chin lock is Raul Castro. He's tough. Al Madrill, I'm sure, is going to erupt here in a minute. Al has been sort of slow getting started, but he continues to work on that mask, and that's got to bother Castro a bit. He has both hands working on the chin of Al Madrill. Madrill is ready. Madrill, whip off the rope. Watch it fly by his shoulder block. Oh, that's Madrill's patented one.
Without a doubt, his favorite move, Bill. We said it before, we'll say it again. His most effective move to fly. Here comes that figure four like I talked about.
And he missed it. Didn't quite put it on there as he got a kick from Castro. Looked like he had this bout won. Good shot. That was an open hand.
Say he gets that figure four on, we know that the match will be over because it's such an excruciating pain that the wrestler can't help but give up on it.
And there's the drill. Watch this move. Five on top. One, over. Two, and three in the drill. That's a with a fine victory.
I said it earlier, just a tune-up match for Madrill, who wants a shot at Wild Bill Irwin. Castro not providing the competition needed for tonight. But then again, just another tune-up match for him and the champion.
Jay, that was a fine victory for Al Madrill. But we were talking about Kevin and Kerry Von Erich, the American Tag Team Champions, coming up in a bout tonight. You got a chance to talk to him a little earlier about how they feel about all this.
Talk to him about how they obtained the belt and what they're going to do tonight to keep the belts. And here, let's take a look at that action right now. I'm here with the American Heavyweight title holders, a belt that they won in San Antonio against McGraw and Bundy. A little something about tonight's bout, Kevin.
Well, they're going to try to take it from us. You know, this isn't for the title, but they're going to try to come on so they get up a little higher on the ladder, and we're just going to make sure that's not going to happen.
A little something from the modern-day warrior.
Hey, Jay, my brother and I are tanned, rested, and ready. We didn't get these tans from laying in the sun. We got them from running on the beach. We're ready, baby.
Hey, back to you. Fire tonight. We're ready to go.
Back to you, Bill.
And there are the American Tag Team Champions, Kevin Von Erich, Kerry Von Erich, and we'll see them very soon. And Jay, there comes Brian Adidas, University of Texas Arlington ex-athlete.
Rising star in the area, hadn't been in the profession too long, just started wrestling full-time a couple months ago. But I'll tell you what, a man who's hit the ground running ever since he's been in professional wrestling, a man who can't help but have a great future, Bill.
And he's very happy about his success so far. He has been working hard, working regularly, and really coming along. He's developing and learning every day. Speaking of learning, the great Kabuki never stops learning. Gary Hart telling me he works out constantly with his martial arts and constantly prepares himself for something more, something greater. They never seem to be satisfied, the Oriental martial arts wrestler.
Always taking their skills to a different plateau, Bill, right. Every time.
He is a fantastic, if not particularly evil wrestler. There he is, the great Kabuki.
Without a doubt, Brian Adidas' biggest match.
And now, here's Mark Lorenz.
This match, one fall with a 10-minute time limit. First of all, from Arlington, Texas, 240 pounds, welcome Brian Adidas. Adidas' opponent tonight, from Singapore, 235 pounds, Gary Hart proudly presents the great Kabuki. Bronco Lubitsch, your referee.
Bronco Lubitsch is the referee, the great Kabuki. You know, I know as an athlete, Jay, you admire people who use their legs well. I admire long-distance runners, particularly. I think there's a grace in style. But when you are a little, you know, relatively small like Kabuki is compared to the Bugsy McGraws and the King Kong Bundys and develop a thrust kick of 70 miles an hour that can just about decapitate somebody, it shows some self-discipline that you have to admire, even with a person as dangerous as Kabuki.
Very dangerous, Bill. I'll tell you what, to be hit with the leg as compared to an arm is no comparison, because the leg muscles are so much larger and so much more deadlier. This man is very lethal.
Now we're going to be showing you, we told you earlier, martial arts practice at Kabuki and the Magic Dragon, who is the protege of Kabuki. And Kabuki knows this inside out. He is a master. But one thing about it, he will tell you through his interpretations and gestures that he is never quite perfect, never has reached the plateau of perfection, which he will always strive for but never attain.
I'll tell you, Brian Deedus has his hands full tonight. If he was not to hold back anything tonight or any other night, this is the night to do it, because Kabuki is one of the more veteran wrestlers that he's wrestled, probably the best wrestler that he has wrestled up to date, because then again, he's not wrestling any of the Von Erichs.
No, it is frustrating for a man like Brian Adidas. Excellent physical condition. He works hard. He has no excess fat on his body. He works out constantly, learns constantly. He has a superb time of his life. And yet, just things like this have got to frustrate him, because he wonders, where did that come from? How do I ever get to that point?
Coming off a big disappointment last night, lost one of the area TV belts to Wild Bill Irwin, a man that he took it from. But Irwin, being the champion that he is, took it back. I tell you what, you can say this and you can say that about Wild Bill Irwin, but the man right now has two belts around his waist.
And he is up. Watch Adidas now. Moves in. That wrist barred very nicely. Trying to stay in very tight on a Kabuki who can explode with chops, karate, judo, anything, kicks, inside thrusts, and destroy a man at even any range. And a distance, watch that.
Very diversified attack, Bill, I tell you. You don't know where he's coming from or what it's coming from. Adidas, he better not make a mistake tonight, because if he does, it'll be all over for him.
So Brian Adidas, the youngster, the great Kabuki, and there's Gary Hart. Good shot of the ball. Gary Hart, the manager, the H&H. Man who's really in charge of all that. Gary Hart.
Gary Hart, a man responsible for bringing into the area Wildfire himself, Tommy Rich.
Yes. And you know, Ric Flair, the World Heavyweight Champion, is going to be around the area in the near future defending the title in some of the areas. And of course, we're looking forward to Reunion Arena August 15th when Kerry Von Erich takes him on.
I was just going to say, I know one man is looking forward to Ric Flair getting his head on. That's Kerry Von Erich.
There's that reverse kick we showed you and we talked about. Just fantastic timing on the part of the little Oriental.
Looks like Kabuki's not being bothered by that damage heel anymore. To reiterate, the damage heel came from a match that he had with the legendary Fritz Von Erich back in Tulsa, Oklahoma, which he hurt his heel and lost the match to Fritz. But right now, doesn't seem to be bothering him at all.
By Adidas, Kabuki used the rollover with him, but Brian Adidas maintained it. Brian's still checking his leg, though. He knows he lifted it a few times. Pain in there. Here he goes again. A drop, roll over, and Adidas nicely done, but look at that flail out. And coming right up to attack is Kabuki. Great Kabuki. In the heart of his culture, painting his face. In a very, every night, a different style. Every time he wrestles, a different style, a different art style. Whatever his mood indicates.
He says he never paints his face the same time twice, the same way twice. Very, I tell you what, he came here tonight with plenty of war paint.
He did. He is all wound up for this young man, Brian Adidas.
We talk about Tommy Rich and Ric Flair coming into the area, but I know anybody out there would like to know that David Von Erich will return to the Texas area real soon. Let me reiterate this, that David Von Erich has not turned on his family. He has been a Von Erich. He's been one of them all his life, and that's something that any of Von Erichs will never do.
That was a bad rumor. Here's a nice rollover reversed by Brian Adidas. Brian doing a nice job out there, staying with Kabuki. Kabuki backing off, looking at him.
Hey,
have to respect you.
That's the word right there, respect. Kabuki better respect this young Adidas, because we've seen it before. All the fighters make mistakes. Adidas taking advantage of it to pin the people. Kabuki better be careful.
There goes Kabuki. Oh, there's that thrust kick. meeting it, probably 140 miles an hour moving into it, and just ripped Brian Adidas right off his feet. Chop across the head, and Brian Adidas got to be shaking and wondering as Kabuki whirls and gets himself all wound up for the kill. A chop again. Brian trying to gain a little time. Get the cobwebs up. Reverse kick. I thought he was coming with a hand in. Kabuki diving into those muscles and nerves of the neck, and Brian Adidas in obvious excruciating pain.
Working on the press performance takes a matter of about 15 to 30 seconds to start affecting the weakened muscles. Kabuki, the master of it. Kabuki, one half of the All Asian Tag Team title. Also, the other half uses the pressure points very well. The student of Kabuki, and that's the Magic Dragon.
Nice coverage by Brian Adidas. Throwing the elbow in twice, a flying drop kick, and Brian Adidas steps right into a right hand. You never walk into Kabuki without being sure you're going to be able to cover yourself. Wow, a shot across the top of the nose and the forehead. That one would knock anyone out right on the back. Somehow Adidas survived that one.
We heard that all the way up here. Kabuki working on the tender underarm area. I'll tell you what, Brian Adidas will be sore in the morning. A very tender area to be working on.
By the way, world-class wrestling crowds have been just fantastic around our area. In San Antonio and Fort Worth and Midland, Odessa, into Oklahoma, all through the Southwest, of course, here in Dallas. World-class championship wrestling. You want to be sure to see it. And right now, Brian Adidas is seeing the effects of that double grasp into the area underneath the armpits. What excruciatingly tough situation he's in right now. But he comes around with a roundhouse right in another one. A for action for Brian Adidas to begin now. Rolling around, a head first. Reverse head drop.
A quicker version of a suplex, but effective way of the suplex. You can break a man's neck that way very easily. Kabuki using his rule-breaking methods, breaking across the eyes of Brian Adidas.
And a thrust, and up and over and out.
I hope they don't disqualify.
I don't think they'll count that as disqualification, although that was close. As Adidas bounced off the rope and flipped up and out and over down onto the concrete floor of the Sportatorium.
Gary Hart over there checking things out. Very happy to see the way his man
Hey, look, coming in here. Hey, it's a gorilla coming into the ring. And look at Kabuki. Kabuki doesn't want that. It Kabuki is gone. And Kabuki, I think, very superstitious young man from the Orient. He just sees this gorilla coming in, and he's not quite sure. Gary Hart is trying to bring him back. Gary Hart is yelling to him, trying to get him to come back in as he goes by us. Bugsy McGraw has pulled another one. Well, he said he'd have a surprise.
I heard of the son of Kong, and now we finally get to meet him.
Oh, Bugsy McGraw is
I tell you what, Bill, I've never seen a fighter change. I've never seen a fan say to somebody who's changed sides of the fence so quick.
I'm going to go down and talk to Gary Hart.
Bill's making his way down to talk to the controversial Gary Hart, the president of H&H. Bugsy McGraw in the ring, looking like the son of Kong. Bronco Rubik's trying to explain to Gary Hart what the heck's going on. Bill Mercer ringside. Now let's go to Bill.
I know this didn't, you don't approve of this, but is Kabuki superstitious about
Oh, man, you know Kabuki comes from the jungle. He sees something like that jump in the ring. If anyone should be fined or anybody should be spent, it should be somebody like McGraw that would do something like that.
Well, he said he was going to surprise us tonight.
Oh, Bill, come on. That Russie's got no place.
Why didn't you get Kabuki to come back? You explained it
to him. He don't understand.
Couldn't you tell him?
Bill, I don't speak that good of a language or nothing else. How am I going to explain anything to you?
Hey, look out. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Gary Hart. Gary Hart.
Another big joke by you and your
ass. I didn't bet, my friend. I didn't know about it. Bugsy. Bugsy. I guess this was your surprise, huh?
Well, somebody told me Gary Hart had a real sweet tooth.
All right, Bugsy McGraw is struck again.
World-class championship wrestling brings you to the Sportatorium on a morning time, a time of workouts for wrestlers, and on this particular day, the great Kabuki and the Magic Dragon are going to show us a part of their martial arts, a lot of their culture, a lot of the other things that they do. You've seen the kendo sticks and the various other things, and it was very nice of you, Gary Hart, to allow us to come in today. I see the Cubs must have won last night because you always wear your jacket after a victory.
As far as I'm concerned, the Cubs win every time they play.
You Cub fans. Well, we can't say the White Sox don't win every day. But again, thank you very much for the opportunity of showing us and talking about what Kabuki and the Dragon are going to do and how they work out.
Well, it's like I say, it's very unusual for us to allow the media to come and into a workout such as this. But I think that the wrestling fans of World Class should know the difference between the martial arts and catch-as-catch-can and Greco-Roman style wrestling that is so familiar in this country. And
I should say, as we look at Kabuki behind us, that he is dressed in the typical samurai, in fact, authentic samurai. If you read Shogun or saw the TV movie Shogun, and recall when that happened back in the early, early part of Japanese history, this was the same type of protective garb and helmet and samurai sword that they used in Shogun. And he said that's over, what, 300 years old?
Over 300 years old. It actually belonged to his great-great-great-grandfather. It originated with him, and it's been handed down through the family, the sword and the full samurai outfit. As you can see, the size of the samurai outfit, you can see the difference in the size of the Japanese and the Chinese race, how they grew over the period of years.
So they maintain their tradition. Now, what are we going to see here today first?
Well, first, I think what we would like to show is the basic difference between the martial arts. As I have said before, that Kung Fu started it all. It's the granddaddy of all the martial arts, and everything was derived from that. The jiu-jitsu was derived from Kung Fu by the Japanese, and karate, more or less, was taken by the Japanese and then into Korea. But the granddaddy of them all is Kung Fu.
Kung Fu was the origin. What about Jiu-Jitsu?
Well, Jiu-Jitsu, as you will see, is utilized the upper portion of the body, use a man's weight against him. And I think we can see that exactly how that works, how you can utilize the weight and leverage against your opponent. Sort of like catch-as-can wrestling, similar, but not quite as many different moves.
Gary, then in jiu-jitsu, you would come to me and I would defend. But in karate, I could be the attacker then. Karate is the attack.
That's basically the gist of it. In jiu-jitsu, I would use your weight and your leverage to my advantage. In karate, I would use my knowledge to attack you in the best way I could.
Gary, in the weapons category of martial arts, what is Tanfu Kendo? How do they fit together?
Well, the first would be, I can't say the word as well as you.
Tanfu?
Tanfu. It's similar to a policeman's billy club, but you have handles on the side. And then the kendo stick is a bamboo stick that is used more or less for pain than it is to actually hurt anyone severely. It's a kendo stick made of bamboo, slit four different ways. As you whack the skin, it sort of pinches it together.
Kerry, what next in the weaponry of Kung Fu that I guess the great Kabuki's a master of?
Well, Kabuki's extraordinarily good with the nunchucks. I think that you'll be very, very interested to see how he could utilize these and the way he trains with them for speed, timing, the whole aspect of the martial arts.
It's really amazing. What can he do next? What are you going to show us next?
Okay, next you'll see a demonstration of the size, which are the silver swords. This weapon hasn't been used probably in 100 years. It's want you to know that the end of these sides have been cut off, so don't worry about anyone getting stabbed, okay?
Gary, thank you very much for allowing us in to see this demonstration today. It was outstanding.
You're more than welcome, Bill.
And I think one thing you might agree with, that anyone who tries martial arts should have expert instruction before doing any of this.
The premier thing is your own safety, especially with the nunchucks. That's very important because a lot of people do use them.
And, you know, we think of martial arts as the attack or the defense, but it is really artistic. It is their culture, it is their background, their oriental beauty that we have seen from these many hundreds of years. It is a martial art.
Let's go ringside.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a one-fall tag team event with a 30-minute time limit. First from Lake Dallas, Texas, 235 pounds, Kevin Von Erich. Making up the other half of the American Tag Team Champions from Lake Dallas at 260 pounds, Kerry Von Erich. Their opponents tonight, a newly formed team representing H&H Limited. First from Duluth, Minnesota, at 265 pounds, Wild Bill Irwin. From Nome, Alaska, 450 pounds, King Kong Bundy. Armand Hussein representing H&H Limited tonight. David Manning and Ron Golubich in the ring.
Well, I must say that Armand Hussein looks like he just came off the Scottish links. There he is.
Very colorful outfit tonight, worn here by the Honorable Armand Hussein. But get a load of the outfit of King Kong Bundy, giving proof that there are cone heads here on Earth.
Certainly a good observation, Jay. And that little suit he's wearing looks like a bathing suit from the 1920s.
Tell you what, we got a great combination here. You got the American heavyweight champion in King Kong Bundy, teaming up with no less the Texas heavyweight champion, Wild Bill Irwin, a great combination. But then again, on the other side, we have the American heavyweight tag team champions in Kerry and Kevin.
And this is a new tag team group that H&H has put together, getting Wild Bill Irwin to come into their fold with King Kong Bundy. And Kerry Von Erich right there working with Irwin. Kerry Von Erich looking forward to his day at a challenge for that heavyweight championship against Ric Flair. And here's a strong young man, 260 pounds from Lake Dallas, ready to work with his brother, the barefoot Kevin Von Erich. Jamming down on the Wild Bill Irwin.
Very aerobatic, we all know that of Kevin. Probably the most aerobatic Von Erich of them all. I'd have to say that the two Von Erichs in the ring tonight create the best combinations that the Von Erichs can put in the ring.
Well, they certainly are the strong, young, exciting men who can just about fly if any two could. And they are the American Tag Team Champions as they battle Irwin right now with Kevin taking command. Nice pull on the arm lock. He's still got that leg and arm scissored. And he makes the contact with Kerry, and they really have it going as they open up this bout. Kerry Von Erich and Kevin against Irwin and King Kong ball-headed Bundy.
We all know there's a problem between Wild Bill and Kevin. Kevin also on the list of men who want Wild Bill's Texas heavyweight champion. Wild Bill also one of the local area TV champions the belt took away from Brian Adidas last night.
There goes Kerry. Watch this move up and over. Irwin not as quick. And they turn around the body. One. Rolling off very quickly. Good arm drag. And look at Kerry Von Erich maneuver, roll. He had him picked up into a body slam, and he turned it around on Wild Bill Irwin. That tells you something of the world-class championship of Kerry Von Erich. By the way, speaking of that, San Antonio coming up this fall in San Antonio, the Alamo City, as Bundy comes in, one of the greatest wrestling extravaganzas ever. world-class wrestling as you've never seen it. We'll tell you more about that as we move into the fall season. And now it's Bundy and Kerry.
Kong said he has it out for the whole Von Erich family for what Kevin did by taking his hair. He felt he was robbed in San Antonio. Kong just got back from Florida where he took all his frustrations out on David, beating David, who was the Florida heavyweight champion.
Kong can't handle that side of thing as Kerry makes a move now with Kevin. They exchange, and here comes Kevin Von Erich, who beat Kong and forced Kong to lose his hair. Kevin, oh, moves right into a jam of the knee into the midsection. But Kevin fights right back. Kevin just seems like a man possessed when he steps in the ring. Good knee jam lift by King Kong Bundy. Bundy now working Kevin over the top rope.
Maybe if Kevin and Kerry were able to work things out a little more last week, they'd have two belts in their hands. There's a bear hug by Kong.
And a big bear that Kevin wrapped up. 450 pounds. Throwing those tremendous muscles around the body of Kevin Von Erich. And he dropped into the knee of Wild Bill Owen.
Okay, this might be a blessing in disguise for Wild Bill, a man who tends to lose his concentration during the match. Especially when he's trying to pin somebody to put him away. With Gary Hart and Mons Hussein, oh no, not a backbreaker.
What a backbreaker, too. He carried that one all the way across the ring.
As I was saying, this might be a blessing for Irwin to give him a little more guidance to make him a truer champion than he already is.
Irwin. Good, quite a job of Kevin just fighting off. Irwin just slipped that one off and comes right back. Whipping Kevin. Kevin made a fine move on a drop kick. A barefoot drop kick and ripped Wild Bill Irwin's head. Kevin working to the corner, slaps it on Kerry. Here comes Kerry doing his war dance. Young warrior, Kevin Von Erich, Kerry Von Erich.
Here's that roundhouse right.
One, two, but not enough. Irwin deep inside, pull that one out. Irwin struggling now as Kerry Von Erich gives him a fly there. A knee drop to the side of the head.
Great move. We saw him use that move on Harley Race at Texas Stadium. It opened up Harley Race's head for about 8 stitches. You talk about Kerry Von Erich, you can't help but talk about the NWA. And the NWA right now, oh, no.
What a move by Irwin as Kerry was up, had a time, but had a time incorrectly because Irwin turned it around, comes across with his moving kick to the head. Another one, and now Irwin is in command. And into the knee of King Kong Bundy. Bundy's turn now against Kerry. Kerry's shaking up.
Hated to see the great tag team of McGraw and Bundy broken up, but it's just one of those things. Looks like they found a great replacement, a great elbow smash by Kong.
Wild Bill Irwin waiting his turn, talking to Armand Hussein. Oh, 450 pounds out of the left arm and shoulder of Kerry Von Erich.
Eric, a man who will meet Rick Flair on the reunion arena in another Star Wars battle. NWA right now with Rick Flair as champion, Sergeant Slaughter, the number one contender, and right behind him, Kerry Von Erich, the modern day warrior. David Von Erich, number 7 in race number 10.
Irwin wants an exchange. He gets it to King Kong Bundy. And Irwin takes over on his battle with Kerry Von Erich. The American Tag Team Champions, Kerry and Kevin Von Erich. And there goes Kerry. And step up kick by Wild Bill Irwin. And Kerry has taken a tremendous amount of punishment. The moving kick again. And Irwin has Kerry Von Erich over the bottom rope and down to the floor.
Very refreshing to see four great wrestlers. Here we go back at the last move, Kerry going off the top rope. Wild Bill pushing him into the rope for momentum. Here comes Irwin with the kick. Kerry not ready for it, takes it to the chest. Great maneuver by Wild Bill.
Back in the ring comes Kerry Von Erich trying to make the tag with Kevin. Kerry had a little chance to rest on the cat on the floor. And Wild Bill Irwin, he saw that warning by David Manning. As Wild Bill Irwin went to the eyes of Kerry Von Erich. Wild Bill in charge right now is King Kong Bundy. And, oh, coming off the rope. Kerry Von Erich figures it out. and drop kicks Wild Bill Irwin. Kerry went up across to get Bundy. But Kerry just temporarily gaining an advantage because Bundy is refreshed and ready to go again. And works hard on Kerry Von Erich, back of the neck. Kerry strong. A hard right uppercut.
What a haymaker by Kerry.
Here's an exchange. Here comes Kevin. And Kevin, he doesn't like Bundy. All over the man. He took his hair in San Antonio. High drop kick. Bundy flying. Trying to get him to go over on a flying mare. Here comes Kevin on a flying body slam on top. Another flying elbow drop to the head of Kevin Von Erich. On top, one, two, three. Wild Bill Irwin and King Kong Bundy beat the American Tag Team Champion.
So much action there at the end, you didn't know who to follow.
Well, what happened, Bundy actually tagged Wild Bill when Kerry and Kevin had him in trouble. So when Kevin came flying on top of Bundy, Wild Bill Irwin saw his opening and made a great move in to destroy Kevin Von Erich.
I tell you what, I like this combination of Irwin and Bundy. It's very effective tonight, and I'm sure we'll see it in the future for H&H.
All the discussion on right now. As Wild Bill Irwin and King Kong Bundy defeat Kevin Von Erich. All right, we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling right after this. Well, Jay Sally, this has been one quiet, crazy night. Bugsy McGraw in a gorilla suit. We've seen Bugsy with the pie of Gary Hart, and the American Tag Team Champions have been beat.
We saw the champions lose. That's what I'm concerned with tonight, that Kevin and Kerry lost tonight, a very important bout. Then we saw a new tag team out of H&H, which was a very effective tag team, in Wild Bill Irwin, the Texas heavyweight champion, and King Kong Bundy, who's the American heavyweight champion.
And, you know, I said before the matches tonight that Bugsy McGraw said he had a surprise. Well, we saw the surprise. Bugsy, you got all your little kids around you here. Have you got any more surprise?
Oh, listen, life, you understand, is full of surprises. Life. The spice of life is variety. And I swear, I promise you to bring you a lot of spice in your life. There are going to be surprises for the next program and the next program and the next program. I'm not going to let a day go by, you understand? H&H and their associates and friends. And Frank Dusick, the next time I face you, you're going to have one, two. Everybody, come on. Let's go. One, two, three. Hi, Mom. Hi, Mom.
All right. Bugsy has surprises. A great bout next week. Wild Bill Irwin and Kevin Von Erich as world-class championship wrestlers.
Wild Bill Irwin, again, the Texas heavyweight champion. Kevin, also on the list of men who wants that belt from him. Looking forward to that great match next week.
So join us on World Class Championship Wrestling next time.